Welcome back to the Create the Good video series about the All of Us research program. My name is Dr. Randy Bloom, and I've had the honor to work alongside both organizations. As a participant ambassador, I've had the opportunity to share information about this research study to people across the country and the value of joining by volunteering your health information. Today we welcome Dr. Susanna Petancheska, Program Director in the Department of Neuroscience at the National Institutes on Aging of the National Institutes of Health. Welcome, Susanna.
Pleasure to be with you, Randy.
Thank you. Please tell our viewers a little bit about yourself.
During my tenure at the National Institute on Aging, I have led the development and I have overseen a number of research programs and research portfolio focused on one hand, understanding the mechanisms of the disease, and on the other hand, focused on therapy development. My most recent and current work is to develop and oversee an array of research programs that apply a big data team science approach to discover the next generation of therapeutic targets for Alzheimer's.
You mentioned the National Institute on Aging as part of the National Institutes of Health. Please tell us about the NIH.
The NIH is a part of the Department of Health and Human Services, and it is the largest biomedical research agency in the world. And as the NIH logo spells out, we're turning discoveries into health.
Please describe what Alzheimer's and other dementias are.
Alzheimer's disease is the leading cause of dementia. Over 60 to 80% of dementia patients, 65 and older, have Alzheimer's disease. The key pathologic features of the disease are the accumulation of a protein fragment called beta amyloid in the spaces between nerve cells in parts of the brain responsible for learning, memory, and thinking, and also accumulation of twisted filaments of another protein called tau inside nerve cells. Other dementias are frontotemporal dementia, about 10% of dementia cases, or dementia with Lewy bodies, 5 to 10%. There are also vascular dementias, as well as dementia with mixed etiology. Currently, over 5.5 million individuals in the United States live with Alzheimer's disease. That is 1 in 10 individuals 65 and older. That number is predicted to increase to close to 14 million by 2050. The current cost, socioeconomic burden of the disease, 2019, based on the Alzheimer's disease facts and figures, is to the tune of $290 billion. That is predicted to escalate to over $1 trillion in 2050. And in addition to this economic burden, it is the crushing and devastating burden on families who do most of the caregiving.
Please share with us some of the contributing factors that may lead to an individual getting Alzheimer's or one of the other dementias.
Now, three factors that we can speak of that are elevating the risk of Alzheimer's. One is aging. Aging is one of the biggest risk factors for Alzheimer's. The second is the presence of the E4 version of the apolipoprotein E. And the third is family history of Alzheimer's, so some genetic component there. These are factors that, of course, we cannot change our family history or genetics or age. But then population-based research has pointed to a whole array of other factors that contribute to an elevated or perhaps lesser risk of Alzheimer's late in life. And these are a whole compendium of factors that are also factors for cardiovascular disease: diabetes, hypertension, obesity, and smoking. Sedentary lifestyle is also associated with poor brain health later in life. Social isolation is another one. On the other hand, if we flip the coin and think about what are some protective factors, educational attainment has been consistently shown to have to be associated with reduced risk of Alzheimer's, physical activity as well, and social engagement.
The All of Us Research Program is striving to create a large data set, including people from all races and genders, ethnicity, social orientation. Why is this type of diverse data set of health information important specifically for this type of research?
We know that genetic factors, racial ethnic differences, differences in socioeconomic status, play a role in determining who will be at elevated risk, and of those individuals who have risk, who will develop symptoms. We just don't understand at a deep enough level through what mechanisms this interplay happens, because having access to this wealth of data will significantly aid in the process of understanding how this happens.
The All of Us Research Program is designed around precision medicine, developing healthcare interventions for individuals. How is this specific design tool beneficial for Alzheimer's and dementia research and hopefully prevention or treatment in the future?
The National Institute on Aging is investing heavily in precision medicine research, starting from genetics, population studies, team science that takes that information to deliver new targets and biomarkers, having at the same time the All of Us program, who is going to capture a wealth of data across individuals from diverse racial, ethnic, socioeconomic backgrounds on the longitudinal basis, will be a tremendous boost for Alzheimer's research as well.
What are some of the areas of promise you see now in our research for Alzheimer's and other dementia prevention or treatment?
One of the exciting areas of research continues to be in the domain of biomarker discovery. Biomarkers are almost the holy grail in every chronic condition. They would help us diagnose people early, identify the participants who can most benefit from trials, or track the responsiveness to treatment. There is also a whole array of an explosion of research along the lines of precision medicine that actually harnesses the power of big data, leverages advances in genomics technologies, and the advent of analytical methodology to build better models of disease and a deeper understanding that can open new avenues for treatment and prevention.
How will you describe some of the direct benefits an individual participant will find in being part of the All of Us Research Program?
Well, some of the unique features of the All of Us Program that really sets it apart from all of our other efforts is that it aims to bring over a million individuals across all backgrounds, all walks of life, as direct partners in research. Spending an incredible amount of effort around protecting the privacy of participant data and engaging participants and working within many communities across the country on building long-term relationships that basically would put participants in the driving seat when it comes to understanding what is being asked of them and what what type of data will be collected and influencing how that data will be used.
Thanks, Dr. Petacheska. This great conversation. I certainly learned a lot about Alzheimer's and dementia research, and I hope our viewers did too.
Thank you very much, Randy.
Thank you. And if you'd like to learn more about the All of Us Research Program, please visit joinallofus.org.